Strong move for Brandon Johns.
7-3, Nebraska down by 4. Verge with the ball down the left lane line. Kick out left sideline in front of the Michigan bench. With it is Bryce McGowan's jab step. Brings it up in the midcourt on the dribble. Chest pass right side, Tominaga. He puts it on the floor. The step back three on the way. Got it! Holy cow! Tominaga with another three, keeping Nebraska in it. It's 7-6.
Oh, man. And he missed an easy one earlier, but he's 2 out of
17 threes now for Tominaga on the year. Huskers down a point. Michigan basketball. Dickinson's got it. Right block. Kick out. Off the left side, Brooks takes the three. In and out. Rattles off. No good. And a rebound and a foul called. I believe it's on Nebraska.
It's on Lat Mayen down low fighting Brandon Johns. And Lat Mayen just got beasted down low. He's got to do a better job of pushing Johns back. He just let Johns walk him right under the rim.
7-6, Nebraska down by 1. 16:40 to go in the first half here from Lincoln. Kent Pavelka, Jake Muehlheisen with you. Big Ten Hoops on the radio tonight. Eli Brooks with a ball. Down to Brandon Johns. In on Walker. The drop step and a foul on Walker. Two free throws coming up for Johns. So back-to-back fouls. Michigan takes it point blank against Nebraska.
And they're just going right to the post on every possession. We talked a ton about Hunter Dickinson. He hasn't even done anything. It's been all Brandon Johns, and he lowered his shoulder right away and gave a blow right to the chest of Derek Walker. Derek needs to fuel that and fall down and draw that charge.
Man has one. Walker has one. Johns at the free throw line, a 62% foul shooter. Not a big body of work. Only 8 free throws coming in. He nails the first one. He's off to a great start. 6 points for Brandon Johns. He had 3 points and a rebound against San Diego State on Saturday in Ann Arbor in 14 minutes of work. Second free throw on the way. Good. 7 points for Johns. And it's 9-6. Michigan, full court pressure, 1-2-2. Three-quarter court. Verge in the backcourt. Still in the backcourt. Brings it across the timeline. And the pass to Bryce McGowan's back to Verge. But see, they've taken 12 seconds off the shot clock here. Here's Verge driving the ball down the left side. Changes hands and lays it in. Alonzo Verge licking his foot to the rim.
A good high pick and roll, and what happened there, Derek Walker sealed his man off, didn't let him come over and block the shot. Alonzo Verge with the finish.
9-8, Nebraska down by 1. Michigan's led all the way. We played 4 minutes in Lincoln. This is Johns with Jones with the ball to Johns. Now it comes to Dickinson, left of the lane line. Double-teamed, kick out, extra pass. Houston drives the ball to the rim and the layup off the window. So the first 2 points of the game for Caleb Houston.
We brought the double team there against Hunter Dickinson and slow in rotation. That's just an easy drive and layup for Houston.
Slow in rotation, but good recognition on the double team and the extra pass by Michigan. Here's a shot by Bryce McGowan's is no good from 3, and the ball's out of bounds off Walker. Walker hits the deck, and we've got a timeout on the floor here with 15:33 to go in the first half. Nebraska down 11-8.
Acres Equipment, Nebraska's premier John Deere dealer with 27 locations across Nebraska and into Kansas. Acres, solutions for every field. Timeout on the floor. This is the Huskers Radio Network.
Did you ever buy something and get more? More than you expected? Emeritus offers insurance, employee benefits, and financial services. But we deliver so much more. The comfort of a human voice when you need it. The confidence of flashing a beautiful smile. The relief that your family can keep living the life they love. The serenity of knowing you've planned well and can enjoy life. That's what we really deliver. We call it fulfilling life. Emeritus. Insurance, employee benefits, financial services, and much more.
Shop the Season of Inspiration sales event at Woodhouse Mazda today. Whether you're looking for a vehicle for your next adventure or an SUV with third row capacity for the whole family, the Mazda lineup has you covered. From the Mazda CX-3 to the Mazda CX-9, the Mazda family of crossovers is designed for the road ahead. Test drive one today at one of our 2 convenient Woodhouse Mazda locations in Bellevue or Omaha, or shop online today, making your car buying easy. This is Woodhouse.
This isn't the start. Before I got here, I started training. And before that, I did something to my back. But my first move was Athletico Physical Therapy. That's where I'd eventually end up, so why not start there? I mean, my therapist immediately found the source of my pain. These are the same physical therapists who work with elite marathon runners. So soon, I was back to running, but without pain. You got this.
It all starts at Athletico. Schedule your free assessment at athletico.com.
Nebraska trailing Michigan 11-8 with 15:33 to play here in the first half. Michigan coming out here 4 of 8 to start the game and got some really easy looks defensively. we're trying to bring that double team against some of their bigs. Brandon Johns early on for Michigan. He's got 7 early points, and Houston has 2 and Brooks has 2, but we had some breakdowns defensively, to say the least. We're bringing the double team, and Michigan doing a really good job of finding an open man, a skip pass primarily, and we got to do a better job with our double team and limiting their looks to throw that and have the ability to throw that pass. We're kind of coming with a slow, unaggressive, just kind of a weak double team. We got to be aggressive and get after their big guys.
Well, it's one thing to get there and stop Dickinson from doing any damage himself, but then you got to dig at it or something.
Yeah, but it's just a slow, just unaggressive, just nobody wanted to stick their nose in there. You got to come in there tough-minded and bring and really kind of make them uncomfortable. Right now, Brandon Johns, Hunter Dickinson, very comfortable down low and able to make the pass out of the double team.
Yeah, and in addition to that, a nice take by Caleb Houston for a layup. So they're going to go inside all night long until Nebraska proves that they are going to have some difficulty with it.
And look, Nebraska going to press for the first time all season long.
Yeah, they will not press the ball. The baseline, Johns will throw it in. Gets it into Jones. Brandon Johns and Devontae Jones. Jones in the backcourt being chased by Nebraska's point guard, Alonzo Verge, brings it across the timeline. Jones, the grad transfer from Coastal Carolina. Here's Eli Brooks with the ball, looking inside for Dickinson. Not available to Houston. Now to Dickinson. Holds it. Faces up against Walker. Little jab step with the left foot. Takes it in the paint or tries to. Drop step. Puts it up and scores it. I don't know how you play any better defense
you
at
don't.
His size.
I mean, he stonewalled him up, and Hunter Dickinson talking trash, but Derek Walker has some things to say right back.
13-8, Nebraska down by 5 points. Dribble weave action. Lat may end to Verge, looking in for Walker. He was there momentarily. Verge late in getting it to him, and it's intercepted by Jones in transition to Eli Brooks. Three ball on the way. Missed it. Rebound to Verge. Verge brings out of the pack on the dribble across the timeline. Chest pass right side to Mann. Mann changes directions back out to Verge. Starts to the right, starts to the left, backs up, and a whistle and a foul.
Got a foul, I believe, on Houston up top.
Yep.
Yeah, got the freshman, the five-star. A little ticky-tack call there for the first time for Michigan's first foul of the ballgame.
Huskers have been whistled twice. Inbounds play. Walker's got it at the foul line. Hands it off to Verge, coming to the left, taking it to the rim, putting it up, missing it. Rebound to Verge. The putback is up, and it's good. Verge is keeping Nebraska in it here. We got 2 threes by Tominaga to start it. Now Verge with a couple of goals. It's 13-10, Michigan by 3. Brandon Johns with the ball coming from the midcourt from right to left. Left-handed dribble, left sideline to Jones. Jones coming left to right. Down the alley he comes, cut off by Mann, the kick out. And the three by Houston, no good. Rebound by Mann, gathered himself, and he's tied up by Johns. Is it a foul or a held ball?
Got a jump ball. Possession arrow to Nebraska. And finally, Lat Mann playing tough, putting his nose in there against Brandon Johns.
Both players hit the deck very hard, quite a hit. They may both need a chiropractor. To find a chiropractic physician in Nebraska, visit nebraskachiropractic.org. Our Nebraska Chiropractic Physicians Association hit of the game early on. And so the arrow is Nebraska's. Down 3, 13-10, 6 minutes into this one. Verge starts right now left, leaves his feet, kicks to Mann, shoots the 3 deep left corner. Got it! We got a tie game at 13. Lat Mann sinks it.
Thank you, Lat Mann. Nice to see him knock one down. Nebraska, 3 of 6 from 3 early in this ballgame.
He scored just 2 points Saturday, Jake. That's his 8th 3 of the year. We're tied at 13 on the left side. Jones right past Verge has Mann in the air. Extra pass, Johns. To Houston, now to Jones, back to Houston, faces up against CJ, right side to Johns, drives the ball. Help defense is there. Great block, but it's retrieved by Dickinson. The putback, no good. Rebound by Verge. What a great play it was by Eduardo Andre at the rim. Verge to CJ, puts it up, no good. Airballed it. Threw it over the whole thing.
That's a tough shot. Wiltshire just coming into the game. He's been in the game for 30 seconds, playing really hard D. That's one of those one we talked about pregame. That's a hard shot, running full speed, coming to a dead stop. That's one that C.J. Wiltshire could pass up next time.
Tominaga in the ball game with Verge, Andre, Mann, and who else is on the floor here? Waiting to come in is Breidenbach for the first time. Dickinson with a handoff to Brooks. Brooks leaves his feet left side to Williams in the corner. Now it's Houston with a 3 ball. Got it to break the tie at 16-13, and Caleb Houston with his first three of the game.
And there was miscommunication on the backside. Coach Hoiberg really upset. Nobody switched.
Tominaga with a three. He can't score it. Ball tapped out of there, out of bounds, and it's off Eduardo Andre.
And Tominaga got a good look there right from the top of the key. Thought it was money. He ran back thinking it was good as well, but some good looks, good set there by Nebraska. Got to do a better job of communicating here on the defensive end.
Breidenbach on the floor, replacing Lapman. And it's 16-13 Wolverines, 12:35 to go in the first half. Dickinson with a standstill three, measured it and scored it over no pressure provided by Andre.
We talked about it. That's his fifth three of the season. He's 5-9 now. He had to get out there and respect his jumper.
19-13, 6-0 run after Nebraska tied it. Verge drives the ball, tries to throw the ball in a wraparound pass to Eduardo Andre, and it's out of bounds off Michigan.
Tried to thread the needle between Jones and Dickinson. Lucky that wasn't a turnover. Went out of bounds. It'll be baseline out of bounds on the left side for Nebraska.
Very fortunate it wasn't a turnover. Frankie Collins in at point guard now. Freshman for Juwan Howard. Breidenbach's got it. Faces up top to against Terrence Williams. Gives it back now to Verge. Back left side to Breidenbach. Drives the ball. Jump stop. Changes hands and hits it with the left hand.
About that move by Wilhelm Breidenbach, showing his versatility. Left-handed jump hook from about 8 feet.
19-15, Huskers down by four. Frankie Collins with the ball between the two circles. Throws it left side to Eli Brooks on the block. It comes again to Dickinson, the big post. Puts it up and scores it. Boy, he's got great touch. He is a pro.
He really does, but you can't force him away from that strong shoulder. He wants to shoot that left-handed jump hook all day long.
Here is Verge with the ball. Changes speeds. Tried to draw the foul from behind. Throws it away. Too hot to handle for Eduardo Andre. Passing in close quarters there. Michigan comes the other way. Williams out to Dickinson, but a travel is called. And a timeout on the floor.
And Michigan leading Nebraska by 6, 21-15, with 11:34 to play. Seatbelt use saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up. This message from the NDOT Highway Safety Office. Stay tuned. This is the Huskers Radio Network.
Hey Husker fans, this is Anne-Marie from the Nebraska Beef Council. Just like the Big Red wins on the court, you can win at the dinner table with great tasting beef. From steaks and roasts to ground beef and kebabs, there are countless ways to create a meal that will have your family cheering for more. Visit beefitswhatsfordinner.com for easy beef recipes, cooking tips, and meal inspirations. Beef, it's what's for dinner in Nebraska.
Brought to you by Nebraska's beef producers and their Beef Checkoff.
Did you know that cigarette butts make up a large portion of microplastics in the ocean, which end up in 70% of seabirds and 30% of sea turtles? Bank of the West is helping to solve this problem by not financing big tobacco, proving that what a bank chooses not to finance can be just as important as what it does. Learn more about what we do and don't finance at bankofthewest.com/change. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Nebraskans are choosing chiropractic for better health. Why chiropractic? Because it is safe, drug-free, and a cost-effective treatment option for back and joint pain. Plus, all generations can benefit from natural chiropractic care. Choose chiropractic first for pain relief, nutrition, or to improve your mobility, athletic performance, or overall wellness. Make chiropractic your first choice for better health. Find a chiropractic physician near you at nebraskachiropractic.org. Get your life back with chiropractic.
Huskers down 6, 21-15. Second media break, 11:34 left first half. Your thoughts, Jake?
Nebraska started shooting the ball pretty well. 3 of 6, missed their last two, but it's really been on the defensive end. We talked about how well we played defensively against NC State and at Indiana. But right now, Michigan 8 of 16 from the floor for 50% and shooting 3 of 7 from 3. Just got way too good of looks and just getting really whatever they want. Their big fella, Hunter Dickinson, right now, he's 3 of 4 and just really doing whatever he wants. And we got to do a better job of mixing it up and coming with a better double team and an aggressive double team. And right now, Michigan only has one turnover. They're averaging just under 15 a game. We have to turn them over so we can get some easy ones. But we have Nebraska, 3 turnovers in this game. But I will say we've gotten some good looks, and we knocked them down early, which is good to see.
Huskers on Saturday will be in Atlanta playing the Auburn Tigers. Why, you say? Well, it's the Holiday Hoops Giving event. 4 games, just single games, 4 of them in one day. at State Farm Arena, Nebraska and Auburn, followed by Clemson, Drake, LSU, Georgia Tech, and Western Kentucky versus Ole Miss. That'll be a 9:30 Central broadcast with a 10:30 tip. A.M.
We're going to get some breakfast early on and get over there. It should be fun. I mean, Auburn's a great team. I'm looking forward to that. Let's take care of business here in Lincoln first. Nebraska finds them down, themselves down 6, 21-15 early in this game.
C.J. Welcher and Kobe Webster now on the floor in the backcourt. Breitenbach, Eduardo Andre, and in the left corner, Bryce McGowan, who takes the handoff, and we've got a whistle and an offensive foul. Screen set off after the handoff by Eduardo.
And that's just so frustrating. Out of a media break, you have a set drawn up, you get Bryce McGowan's back in the game, and you have a turnover. And that call could be called so many times during the game. Let that one go.
Yep, that foul called by Rob Kuhneman, officiating the game with Keith Kimball and Rob Riley. Here's Williams with a basketball for Michigan. Up top right side in front of the Husker bench to Dickinson. Here comes the double team over the left shoulder with a hook shot. Double team was late. And it's another point-blank shot for Dickinson. 23-15, biggest lead of the night. 8 points now with 9 minutes gone first half. Michigan ahead. Here's Eduardo Andre with a handoff to Webster. Drives, kicks, Breitenbach. He drives the ball into the free throw circle. Down to the right side, off to Kobe Webster. Screen for him. He rejects the screen to a cutting. Bryce McGowan's hit at the rim. Couldn't finish. And the rebound to Eli Brooks. Down the floor to a streaking Collins. In the paint to Dickinson. Kicks it out. Extra pass. Eli Brooks. Open look. Missed it. Short. Rebound run down by Nebraska's Bryce McGowan. Spins away from a defender. Falls down. Flips it off to Eduardo. And he tried to throw it to CJ. And the Huskers dodged a big bullet there.
Hot potato out there. Nobody wanted that basketball. It was ping-ponged all over the place. Nebraska dodging the bullet, turned it over, but Michigan could not quite handle it. But, man, I thought Bryce got hammered driving the basketball. I thought he was going to go up and try to dunk one, but may have just lost the handle on it.
Walker back in the ball game, and Eduardo Andre will sit as Nebraska will inbound the ball down 8 points, 23-15. 10:26 to go, first half of play. After the game Saturday in Atlanta against Auburn, Nebraska with 7 days off.
Be a nice little break for everybody, but I'm not sure what they're looking at. The ref over at the monitor looking at something.
It's Rob Riley. And the other two officials are out on the floor, not helping Riley out. Maybe it's a clock issue, Jake. I'm not sure.
Oh, shot clock's not working right now, so the shot clock's showing zeros. So they're going to get that reset. They're going to put 21 seconds back on the shot clock, so it'll be Nebraska basketball, right side baseline out of bounds.
Seatbelt use saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up. This message from the MDOT Highway Safety Office. So Nebraska's basketball, Huskers need a hoop here. They came from 6 points down to tie the game at 13. But have been outscored 10-2 since. Inbounds play. Webster loses the ball. It's out of bounds off Michigan.
It's a tough spot to throw the ball inbounds. You can't move your stationary as the inbounder. Nebraska got to do a better job of getting open for their teammate.
McGowan's now the bigger player. Inbounds the ball with a pass to Walker, popping out to catch it. Now to Breitenbach. Underhand and shovel pass to Bryce McGowan's coming left. Pull-up jump shot on the way. It's short. And the rebound by Caleb Houston of Michigan. Up by 8 points, the Wolverines. And they have been effective, really effective in the half-court offense. Williams left corner, up top to Brooks. They swing it right. Jab step on the drive by Houston. Poke away by Breitenbach into the hands of Nebraska's McGowan's. Good takeaway by Breitenbach there. Here's Kobe Webster. Crossover dribble, drives. Leaves his feet, throws it out to Breitenbach. Drives past one defender along the baseline. Switches hands, can't finish. Rebound Dickinson of Michigan.
Pretty good move, though, by Wilhelm. Putting it on the deck, but needs to use the glass on that one and bank it home.
Collins with a basketball, a dribble, high post back to the basket. Dickinson faces up against Walker. Throws it left sideline. The Collins back to Dickinson. Doubled on the catch. Back up top right side. Three ball on the way. It's good by Williams. And they just recognize that double right away and pass to the open man.
Yeah, just skipping that thing all around, making the extra pass. Michigan on a 13-2 run of the last 3.5 minutes.
Up by 11, their biggest of the game. Webster with the ball. Up top it comes to McGowan's between the two circles. Throws left side to Breidenbach, posing with it, coming to it is Wiltshire, high post Walker. They split the post, kicks it right, and Kobe Webster misses the three, and the rebound out of bounds off Houston, but they say last touch by Breidenbach, who was behind him.
Man, I thought that was going to be off
Michigan,
and they did. They changed it. It'll be Nebraska basketball. It's staying home, so good hustle by Breidenbach. Keep that possession alive for the Cornhuskers. We got to get something going.
You betcha.
One of our last seven on the offensive end.
Danger zone for the Huskers. Down 11. Webster into McGowan's in the corner. Drives the ball. Strong to the rim. Finishes in an and one for Bryce McGowan's. Knocking down Frankie Collins, who was there to help defensively.
Let's hope that gets Bryce going. He's been and looking a little lethargic here tonight at PBA.
Well, he wasn't feeling well.
You mentioned hadn't been feeling good at all, but he has been a little bit slow moving. Let's hope that gives him a little shot of energy. We need him to be aggressive on both ends of the floor for Nebraska.
Verge back in. Webster will sit. Tominaga on the floor with Verge in the backcourt with McGowan's, Walker, and C.J. Wiltshire. Free throw good by Bryce. He's now 49 of 58 from the foul line this year. 85%, 26-18, 8-point lead. Nebraska's in a zone, Jake.
First time we show the 2-3 zone, a little morph into a 3-2 as well.
Passes right side, up top it comes to Collins, threads the needle, bad pass, picked off by Tominaga, retrieved by Wiltshire, in transition the Huskers. Tominaga's got the ball, he's got the big on him, big Dickinson shoots the three, missed it, and the rebound taken down by Caleb Houston of Michigan. In transition, chest pass across the line to Williams, measures the three, drains it. Terrence Williams, the third, sophomore out of Clinton, Maryland. And that gives Michigan a 12-point or an 11-point lead again at 29-18. Verge with the ball, dancing around, kicks it out. Wiltshire wide open, missed it. Rebound to Walker, second chance, back cut to Wiltshire. Stops, puts it up, bump, no foul. Dickinson all over his back. Come on. Come on.
A lot of contact there by the big fella Dickinson.
Come on. 29-18, it's Nebraska down 11 and a timeout on the floor with 7:56 to go in the first half. Wiltshire clearly fouled there and no call. We'll be back after this timeout on the Huskers Radio Network.
Wait, timeout, Mom. Instead of using ketchup on your hot dog, pour on some of this Dorothy Lynch. Good, huh?
Yeah, talk about serving up an ace.
Did you see that? She spiked it.
Yes. Am I going to be watching you play for the Huskers someday?
How about you get me some more pizza, and then we talk about it.
Share the tradition of one-of-a-kind flavor that goes with anything, game day or any day. Dorothy Lynch, endless flavorabilities.
This year, don't just get ready. Get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
Your husband is pretty handy to have around. He makes the world's best mac and cheese. He's in the Tickle Monster Hall of Fame. And he can teach anyone how to throw strikes. But a busted pipe and a basement full of water?
Honey, I think we need a plumber.
He's a little out of his league. That's where a homeowner's policy from Shelter Insurance comes in handy. We'll help get your house back in order and your husband back to what he does best.
See Agent Jackie Rowan in Lexington or Megan Fails in Cozad.
Nebraska trailing by 11, 29-18 with 7:56 to play here at PBA. Chiropractic care keeps people of all ages healthy and active and is a safe, natural, affordable healthcare choice. Chiropractic is proven to improve mobility, prevent injury, and treat pain. Find a chiropractor near you at nebraskachiropractic.org. Get your life back with chiropractic. Nebraska struggling mightily on the offensive end. One of their last eight. We started shooting from downtown 3 of 6. We missed our last five, now 3 of 11. The possession prior, really good set, had Wiltshire wide open in the right corner, and he flat out missed it. Wiltshire's 0 for 2. We got to have some guys knock down those shots. That's what they're here to do, and they're wide open. And then defensively, Michigan 6 of their last 7, able to get out to this 11-point lead. We went to that zone, turned them over the one time. We're just struggling on the offensive end, unable to get any rhythm. The crowd's not into the game. Just kind of been a It was just a slow-moving game, slow-energy game for Nebraska players and Nebraska fans.
You were silent, weren't with me. Wasn't that a foul down there?
I was yelling with you. I was trying to yell right with you. And Dickinson, you know, his size and I guess his reputation in the league, knowing that he's an all Big Ten caliber player, the refs aren't going to call that whistle on.
Well, I mean, he can get to the ball, but that doesn't mean he hasn't mauled you with the body.
And Wiltshire got hammered, and Hoiberg wanted the same call too. But we got to have guys take that contact and finish. That's one still that Wiltshire should finish.
So on the floor, Alonzo Verge back on the floor. Lat Mahan, Tominaga, McGowans, and Walker. As Michigan will have the ball, sideline in front of right in front of us here, as Brooks inbounds it. Back in the game is Jones, the starting point guard, to Williams, to Jones. The bounce pass to Eli Brooks. Brooks inserts the pass, high post to Williams, jump pass, right corner, baseline drive, and dumps it off in the layup. Good by Williams. Nice assist there by Zeb Jackson, a 6'5 sophomore from Toledo in the ball game. Wearing number 3, he hasn't played much this year. It's now 31-18, 13-point game. 3-point goal no good by Bryce McGowans. Run down by Dickinson. Huskers in a world of hurt right now. Jackson fires the 3. Lefty scores it. 16-point lead, Jake.
Now we're not getting back on defense. Playing with that same energy level we saw on the road. We're letting our lack of offense really impact our intensity and focus and effort on the defensive side.
I wonder if they even knew Jackson was in the game. He just got in, and nobody was guarding him.
No, there was nobody within 10 feet of him. We miss a wide-open one, Bryce McGowans, and they get out in transition. Nobody's talking. Nobody's sprinting back. And, again, I think the lack of offense is really impacting our energy on defense. And just that's one thing. You can control how hard you play. And it's just so frustrating as a coach to watch that happen and not sprint back and try to turn the tide. Nebraska down 16, 34-18 with 7:20 to play. And Michigan just rattled off an 8-0 run over the last minute.
Well, they've outscored Nebraska 21-5 since the score was tied at 13. Here's Verge with a ball, with a handoff to Mahan, with a handoff to Tominaga. Dribble weave action up top. Verge winds up with it, drives it. On the corner, it's Wiltshire back to Verge. Jab step against Jones. Pump fake. Tries to drive, draw the foul. No whistle. Puts it up and in. So Verge got it to fall. His 5th and 6th points. 34-20. Nebraska down by 14 points. Need a stop on defense. Zeb Jackson up top to Brandon Johns back in the game. High post back to the basket. Walker's gone him out on the floor. Little stick arm defense. Left side to Jackson. Left to right. Verge lost him. The 3 is no good. The rebound by Lat Mahan, and it's out of bounds off Michigan.
Man, I thought that was off of Lat Mahan. I think he was fighting his own teammate. I couldn't tell who that was. Blocked off and screened off by the referee here, but be Nebraska basketball. Got to go on a little run here before the break.
Well, they scored the ball on a take by Verge, and now they get a stop. Here's Verge into the front court with a handoff. Bounce pass. Tominaga winds up with it back to Verge. A screen by Breidenbach. Verge shuffles it back to Breidenbach. Shoots the 3 off the back of the rim. No. And the rebound to Jones. Michigan the other way, right to left. Long pass. This is Eli Brooks. Brooks shoots a pass off the left side. Williams has got it on the block. Williams trying to post up inside against Lat. Turnaround jump shot. Got it.
It's too easy. Get right to the middle of the paint, right above the restricted circle. That's just too easy for the Wolverines.
36-20, Nebraska down 16 points. With it is Breidenbach, elbow left side, one dribble. Coming to it is Verge, behind the screen of Breidenbach, shoots the 3, shot blocked. A little set shot there, slow in getting it off, and it was rejected. Here's Williams with the ball. Out it comes to Jones, kicks it out to Brooks, shoots it over Wiltshire, missed it. Long rebound out to Jones off that long miss.
And nobody was around. That was just an unfortunate bounce for Nebraska.
Jones with the ball, dancing around a screen up top by John, shoots the 3, scores it. Verge was by himself, 1-2, and the 3 drained, giving Michigan a 19-point lead at 39-20.
And this place is just silent. We talked about how we needed the crowd, but you know what? These players need to give the crowd something to cheer about. And the energy level on defense, offensive rebounds. I mean, there's just no energy at all in this place. And it's going to start with the players. And there's a lot of game left. We saw ourselves down 19 against the Creighton Blue Jays earlier this season and battled back and tied the dang game. So there's a lot of game left. And these guys need to get on it and figure something out quick. And right now, just Michigan basically getting whatever they want on the offensive end.
It was 13-13. Since that point, Nebraska's been outscored 26-5. No, that's not right. 26-7. 39-20 right now, down 19 points with 5.5 to go. First half of play. Alonzo Verger Jr. with the ball between the circles. Screen for him by Breidenbach. Threads his way down the lane. Kicks it out to Monaga. Three. No good. Put back no good by Breidenbach. Where Breidenbach's fouled. Converged on and dumped. Hit hard to the floor. So the foul on Michigan. Zeb Jackson. And the Huskers will have it end line out. 5:23 to go. The crowd at a hush here. It's louder in Love Library than it is right now here at the PBA. Mann with the ball with a handoff back to Verge, who threw it in. Now skip past left side with it. Wiltshire, a dribble, the shot. No good. Tip try, no good by Breidenbach. Defensive rebound by Jones. Michigan controlling this thing, leading by 19 with the ball. Jones, a little whip pass up top left side. Houston's three, no good. Just grazed the far side of the rim, and the rebound run down by Verge in transition. Verge picked up by Williams, now by Jones. Verge dancing around, driving the ball to the rack, puts it up, draws the foul. Two free throws for Alonzo here.
And that's just Michigan's third foul of the game. That'll send Verge to the line shooting two. We got to get this thing to single digits at halftime. 4:53 to play, down 19.
39-20 the score with 4:53 to go in the half. Huskers Saturday in Atlanta. Against the Auburn Tigers, who are 7-1 on the season. Auburn off to a really good start. Free throw good by Alonzo. 7 points for him in the half.
Alonzo's played good. He's dribbled it a little too much at times, but for the most part, he's been very solid to start this game. And 7 points and four rebounds. He's leading right now Nebraska in rebounding. That's good to see our guards crashing down hard and trying to fight after some rebounds.
Second leading scorer on the Huskers team this year, 15-point average, 5.6 rebounds, and 5.8 assists per game. He knocks in both foul shots, cutting the lead to 17, and we have stoppage because of wetness on the floor. So they'll take care of that.
And Nebraska's going to extend their pressure again. We've showed some press and some full-court pressure here in this first half, and that kind of energized Nebraska for a little bit, and then we kind of went away from it. So Alonzo Verge going to pick up full court.
Yeah, now they're backing off. A little 1-2-2 look now. Picked up at the timeline is Caleb Houston. Now it's Jones with the ball to Dickinson out from underneath. Dribbles the ball a couple of times. Houston knocked down, gets back up. Back cutting on the left side. It's Houston Jackson shooting the three, missing it. Rebound tipped back to Houston. Caleb Houston fakes, kicks. In the right corner, it's Jones driving on Verge. Now on the left side, Houston with a long three. It's good. Caleb Houston with another three for Michigan. His second three of the night. It's 42-22. Nebraska down 20 at home in the first half. Here's a drive by Verge to the rack and finishes off the rim. He's in double figures with 10.
Not sure how he got that one up over the seven-footer Dickinson. What a finish by Alonzo Verge.
Jones driving, kicking. Johns deep corner left three. Good. So Brandon Johns with in double figures with a couple of threes and 10 points. 45-24, Verge driving in the paint, scores it, and a whistle. And we got an offensive foul, do we?
I don't know what they called. Got it on Breidenbach.
Verge is going to get credit for the basket, though. We've got a timeout on the floor with 3:50 to go here in the first half of play. Husker men's basketball brought to you by your Midwest Ford dealers. Visit buyfordnow.com. This is Big Red Basketball.
This year, don't just get ready. Get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer.
Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
Here is a before winter to-do list from JTech Construction. Let's start with windows. Triple pane window technology has saved homeowners countless dollars on heating and cooling bills. Siding serves a crucially important purpose, protecting your home and insulating it from adverse weather conditions. And don't forget about your roof. Designing your roof should be simple and painless, and JTech offers several payment plan options. One more thing on your to-do list, call JTech Construction, the official exterior experts of the Huskers.
Nebraska trailing the Michigan Wolverines by 19 here in Lincoln, Nebraska from Pinnacle Bank Arena. 45-26 with 3:50 to play. And Michigan just getting whatever they want on the offensive end. 17-30 from the field for 57%. And KP, they've made 9 threes already.
Yep.
They're shooting 9 of 18 from 3 for 50%. So they're just scorching on the offensive end. Nebraska, on the other hand, 10 of 30 from the field. We started off the game 3 of 6 from 3. We've missed our last 10 attempts from downtown. We are now 3 of 16, and we're just not attacking at all. We have 2 assists on our 10 made field goals, so a lot of one-on-one basketball. Our energy on the defensive end has been lacking, to say the least. It's nothing near to where it was when we were on the road at NC State or on the road at Indiana. So we can cut into this lead. There's 3:50 left in the half. And what these guys need to try to do is cut this to a single-digit lead, 10 points or less, 10, 9, 8 points, which we can do. But right now, we have to get some stops. Michigan just imposing their will on that end of the floor, getting absolutely whatever they want.
At one point, Jake, Nebraska was 3-for-6 from 3. They've missed their last 10 three-point field goal attempts, 3-for-16. And a telling stat for Michigan tells you how they're playing offensively. They've got 11 assists on 17 made baskets.
They're sharing the ball. They're whipping it around. And we're bringing that double team against their big guys down low, and it's just not an aggressive double team. And they're able to make passes out of it and really make a good, hard, crisp pass instead of that lob where if they're throwing a lob over the top, that gives us time to recover. But right now, they're just blasting that thing all over the place, and guys are knocking down shots. 9 of 18. 9 made threes already for the Wolverines, and they're coming in, I believe, just averaging 7 a game.
So Eduardo Andre entered the game at one point, gave him a shot in the arm with a blocked shot, but he's sitting now, and the Huskers are in a little soft zone, and here's a foul called as Lat Mann fights over the top to get to the top of Johns underneath.
And that'll be Lat's second foul of the game, and he's been in foul trouble a lot. And that'll take him out of the game and insert Derek Walker.
And Walker comes in. He'll play in the middle along that inbounds defense, inbounds past Dickinson. Down the left side is Jones. He's blocked at the baseline. Help defense there to Monaga, and Walker trying to impede his progress to the rim.
And that's on Derek Walker.
It's his second.
And that's his second. So the foul's starting to mount up.
Again, end line out for Michigan under their basket. It's a 19-point Wolverine lead with 3:41 to go in the first half here in Lincoln. Into the ballgame, Keon Edwards, and Walker will leave with the two fouls. So Edwards, Breidenbach, and McGowan's along the front line. The guards are Tominaga and Verge. And the inbounds pass to Houston. Swings it right side over there to Jackson. Now to Johns. Ooh, big mismatch here. A kick out off a double team and extra pass. Another extra pass. Jones, a dribble. The three is up. No good. He was too open. Rebound to Tominaga. Across the timeline, left side. Down the left side, flips it off the Verge in front of the Michigan bench. Comes left to right off the high ball screen by Breidenbach. He comes left, he comes right to the rack, puts it up, can't finish. And the rebound by Zeb Jackson for Michigan. Cross court right side, Jones in the corner to Johns with a pump fake, and he travels with the basketball.
Finally, Michigan turns one over. The Verge is dribbled into a crowd there. That's a tough shot. Just a lot of one-on-one basketball for Nebraska in this first half.
Tied in turnovers, 4 apiece for the Huskers and the Wolverines. 3 minutes and change to go in the half. 45-26, Michigan by 19 points. McGowan's has been held to 3 points. To Breidenbach, another three on the way. This one looks good, but is not. Put back up and good by Bryce McGowan's, who timed it beautifully.
It's a great play, great hustle play by the freshman. I thought Breidenbach was good, too. Looked really nice leaving his hands.
Cuts the lead to 17 points. Michigan with the ball. Medium pivot right side. Dickinson against the smaller Breidenbach. Double team comes. The kick out. The extra pass to Brooks. Three ball up. No good. They crash the boards. It's out of bounds. And it's last touched by Nebraska's Breidenbach.
Man, Michigan just beasting us down low.
Yeah, they are.
On that defensive rebound. They just pushed us underneath and able to keep the possession alive, but we dodged a bullet to start. Eli Brooks missed a wide open one.
So Michigan will inbound under their basket. 20-second reset on the shot clock. Jones to throw it in. Point blank inside. Brandon Johns fouled from behind by Keon Edwards. And two free throws coming up for Brandon Johns.
We're in that 2-3 zone. On the baseline out of bounds, and the three guys below left a gap there, and there's an easy pass to Brandon Johns, and it'll give him a chance to extend his point total. He's got 10 already in this game.
As you said, they have beasted Nebraska down low, and that's been that, and sharing the ball on the offensive end has been the difference in this game. The free throw good by Johns, and that extends the lead to 18 again, 46-28. Johns with 11 first-half points, now make it 12, 47-28. Here is Verge in the backcourt, reached in on and fouled by Houston out of their 1-2-2 three-quarter court press.
And that's Houston's second foul. Man, I thought Houston picked him clean, too. I thought that was going to be a dunk on the other end. But that 1-2-2, all that's been to do is slow you down. And they've used it. That's their third time they've done it on Nebraska.
Here's Verge across the timeline in the game with a handoff to Tominaga. Comes to the right, flips it off to Keon Edwards. Now between the circles to Verge, who comes left, unguarded, shoots the three, in and out. Rattle out and no good. Rebound by Dickinson to Jones. Into the front court, the Wolverines ahead 47-28. 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the half. The drive down inside and the dunk by Johns. Great pass in there by Kobe Bufkin. In the ball game now for Michigan. Here's Verge to Breidenbach. Lays it up with a left hand. I thought he shuffled his feet there.
I did too. Thought he was going to dunk it there for a second. Great find by Alonzo Verge. And way to take the contact by the freshman.
Cuts the 21-point lead down to 19 at 49-30. A minute and 40 to go in the first half. Jones with the ball. Hounded near the timeline. Out by Verge. Here's Brooks with the ball. Pass in the left corner. And we got an offensive foul on Dickinson. Pushing Breidenbach to the floor.
And Wilhelm plays hard, doesn't he? He's always fighting down low, and Dickinson not happy with that call. And I think we may have got away with one, but finally a call goes Nebraska's direction.
Down 19, though, Jake, 49-30. Verge takes the inbounds pass from Keon Edwards. Across the timeline, Verge comes against Jones all the way to the hoop, puts it up and in. Used his body to shield off the much bigger Dickinson. In the first half, now 14 points for Alonzo Verge.
The one-man press break against that 1-2-2. Verge taking it coast to coast.
49-32, Nebraska down 17 points, a minute and 14 seconds to go in the half. Jones, the transfer point guard from Michigan to Eli Brooks. 133 games in the maize and blue for Michigan, as we said earlier. On the right side, it's Johns to Dickinson. Turnaround Jay up no good. Rebound by Nebraska and a foul. Jones over the back of McGowan. So are they going to say it just went off his out
of
bounds?
Yeah, they're just going to say that Jones poked it free from the grasp of Bryce McGowan. So it'll be Nebraska ball down 17 with 59 seconds to play.
Well, maybe two for one here, and you can get it down to 13 points now. Right now down 17, and here's Verge with a drive. The step back off the window, no good. Rebound defensively by Michigan. Brandon Johns to Jones. Slick pass in front of the Husker bench to Brooks. To Dickinson, shoots the three. In and out. Rebound by Breidenbach. That was all but 3 points there for Dickinson.
Good. Yeah.
Here's Bryce McGowan's with the ball. Dancing around up top the Breidenbach left side. Kobe Webster back in the game at the top of the circle on the left side. Verge. He'll drive the ball. Pitch it out. Got pinned in underneath. Turned it over. Michigan the other way. Ball on the floor. Breidenbach scrapping for it. Flips it out to Keon Edwards down the floor to Verge. Led him too far. But I'm going to say that's the play of the game right there for Nebraska. Breidenbach's effort on the defensive end.
I mean, you got to love that.
Great Western Bank play of the game. Great Western Bank offers big bank convenience with all the advantages of a local community bank. Great Western Bank.
He's just diving, hustling, scrapping. He's the one guy that's really played hard here in the first half for the Cornhuskers.
Too bad they couldn't capitalize and score off the turnover, but great effort there. Here's Jones to Dickinson. Missed the three this time, and the rebound, Breidenbach over the top, over the back, and a foul either on him or McGowan's, one of the two. I think it's on Breidenbach.
It's on Breidenbach. What a bad call.
Three fouls on him. No, excuse me.
Jeez.
That's just his first.
Oh, they got it on. They got it on Edwards.
Oh, they did.
Yeah, they got it on Edwards.
And that puts Brandon Johns Jr. at the free throw line with 0.2 seconds left to go in the half. Nebraska down 17. Brandon Johns with a dozen in the first half. He fires and scores. Recruited successfully out of East Lansing, Michigan, out of the lap of Michigan State. And playing for Michigan. Lost his starting job to the freshman, Diabate, who is ill tonight. Started tonight, hits both foul shots. And there's the horn, there's the half. And the Huskers are in a big, big hole here at halftime at home. Trailing Michigan at halftime, 51-32. Stay with us. Our halftime show begins after this timeout on the Huskers Radio Network.
Farmers don't always like talking to bankers, but some farmers really like their high school shop class. So here's a high school shop teacher to tell you about Dakota Max 30-year fixed-rate loans.
Hey, careful, Terry.
Want to free up some cash every month, add liquidity, refinance debt?
Stop horsing around, Lewis. You remember what happened to Tommy Woodruff?
Get yourself a 30-year loan from Dakota Max.
Hi, it's Boyd Minery from Dakota Mac. Call me at 402-463-4637 to learn all about our competitive rates on ag real estate loans.
You already got the hat, the jersey, maybe even the occasional red and white face paint. So kick things off right this season and add the FNBO Husker Visa debit card to the list. Pay loud and proud for every Husker decal, t-shirt, or hot dog at the game. Wear your heart on your sleeve and in your wallet with the Husker Visa debit card. Free with any checking account from FNBO, the Bank of Husker Nation. Get yours today at fnbo.com/Huskers. Member FDIC.
Welcome to Ag Answers, where we answer common questions related to farming and ranching. Today's topic, animal agriculture. There's been a lot of talk suggesting that giving up meat is good for the environment. However, livestock emissions only account for less than 4% of greenhouse gas emissions, according to the Environmental Protection Agency. Also, by reducing meat in your diet, you're missing out on all sorts of beneficial nutrients like protein, iron, and zinc. This message is brought to you by Nebraska's corn and soybean farmers.
Halftime in Lincoln, Michigan, 51, Nebraska, 32. Acres Equipment, Nebraska's premier John Deere dealer, with 27 locations across Nebraska and into Kansas. Acres, solutions for every field.
Nebraska finding themselves down 19, 51-32 at the break. And tonight's halftime stats are brought to you by Cornerstone Bank. Starting with the visiting team, Michigan Wolverines, scorching on the offensive end, 50%, 18-36 from the field. Hit 9 threes out of 22 attempts for 41%. Hunter Dickinson, their All-American, has 9 points and 6 rebounds. Caleb Houston, their 5-star freshman, the Big Ten preseason freshman of the year, has 8 points and 3 rebounds. Brandon Johns, who got his starting spot back because his teammate is ill, had 16 points and 3 boards. And Terrence Williams off the bench with 10 points. Michigan has 7 offensive rebounds for 12 second-chance points. For your Nebraska Cornhuskers, shooting just 35% from the field. They're 3 of 18 from deep, and they were started off the game 3 of 6, so missed their last 12 attempts from downtown. Alonzo Burge Jr. leading the way, has 14 points. 4 rebounds and 3 assists. Bryce McGowan's has 5 points and 4 rebounds. Keze Tominaga, he's 2 of 6 from downtown, has 6 points. And Wilhelm Breidenbach off the bench playing extremely hard, has 4 points and 3 rebounds. Cornerstone Bank is committed to providing you game-changing solutions for your financial needs. Bank on a solid foundation. Cornerstone Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender. More on the halftime show after the break. You're listening to Big Red Basketball.
You live in a smart home powered by Cox Internet, so you're not thinking about the pizza delivery. You're thinking how nice it is to get everyone together for a fun night. You're not thinking about the pizza, maybe just a little.
Cox Home Life, show me the front porch camera.
Pizza!
View your Cox Home Life cameras right from your TV using your Contour voice remote. Visit cox.com/thisishome to learn more.
Advertised features require subscription to Cox Internet and Contour TV. A high-speed internet connection is required. Home Life Security Services subject to Home Life Security Service Agreement. Cox Home Life Services provided by Cox License Entities. See cox.com/licenses.
Freddy's Frozen Custard and Steak Burgers is all about the good and creating more of it. More drive-thru celebrations. More weekend traditions. More family dinners and lunches. More car picnics and road trips. More desserts. Maybe more second desserts. More celebrating being together as much as we can. There's always room for more good and more Freddy's. Keep the good going with a taste that brings you back.
Visit one of our Freddy's 4 Lincoln area locations.
As the Huskers head to halftime, Frank is off the couch and headed for the fridge. Ooh, but he can't make it because he's so cold. The furnace is out again. But wait, he sees an opening. SOS! SOS, he screams and calls 391-2336. SOS Heating and Cooling, his favorite Luxair dealer. Boy, he made the right call today as SOS is already on the way. SOS is your trustworthy company since 1950, and with Luxair, you get free 10-year labor warranty with a new system. Call 391-2336 or visit soshvac.com today.
This year, don't just get ready, get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
Let's pause 15 seconds for station identification on the Huskers Radio Network.
Hey friends, do you need to buy or sell heavy equipment, farm machinery, trucks, or trailers? Well, Auction Time is the industry-leading online auction platform for big machines. Get worldwide exposure and earn top dollar for your equipment. Visit auctiontime.com today. Coming up Saturday, Nebraska against Auburn, the Tigers of the SEC, in the Holiday Hoops Giving event in Atlanta at State Farm Arena. That's going to be a morning tip. 10:30 Central tip, 9:30 broadcast along the network. Huskers against the Tigers. Four games that day at the State Farm Center. Clemson, Drake, LSU, Georgia Tech, and Western Kentucky versus Ole Miss, the other three. Auburn is ranked 16th in the initial net rankings as Bruce Pearl has coached the Tigers to a 7-1 start. Their only loss was to UConn in two overtimes, 115-109. They have posted wins over Syracuse by 21 points, as well as Central Florida, Yale, Loyola of Chicago, South Florida, Louisiana Monroe, and Moorhead State. Their leading scorer, Jabari Smith, a 6'10 freshman, 16-7. KD Johnson, 6-foot guard, 15 points a game. And they've got Wendell Green at 10 points a game, another guard, and big post 7-1 center, Walker Kessler at 8 points a game. That's Saturday in Atlanta, Nebraska, against the Auburn Tigers. Coming up next, our major halftime college scoreboard show on the Huskers Radio Network.
Tailgating pros agree that Lucille's Famous Fried Chicken and More at Sapp Brothers scores big with Husker fans. Be the MVP of your tailgate party this year and let Lucille's do the cooking. Stop by Sapp Brothers Travel Center or visit www.sappbros.net to find out how you can elevate your tailgate party with Lucille's Famous Fried Chicken, celebrating 50 years of fueling America's heartland and welcoming guests. Sapp Brothers is proud to be an official sponsor of Husker Athletics.
Hy-Vee Mealtime To Go is mealtime made easy. Just order delicious meals online for convenient curbside pickup or have it delivered. Want breakfast? Hy-Vee Mealtime To Go. Need lunch? Hy-Vee Mealtime To Go. Doing dinner? Hy-Vee Mealtime To Go. Get pancakes, burgers, fried chicken, lasagna, high chai Asian dishes, sushi, pizza, and more. If you're craving it, Hy-Vee Mealtime To Go has it with curbside pickup or delivery. Order today at Hy-Vee.com/mealtime.
You already got the hat, the jersey, maybe even the occasional red and white face paint. So kick things off right this season and add the FNBO Husker Visa debit card to the list. Pay loud and proud for every Husker decal, t-shirt, or hot dog at the game. Wear your heart on your sleeve and in your wallet with the Husker Visa debit card. Free with any checking account from FNBO, the bank of Husker Nation. Get yours today at FNBO.com/Huskers. Member FDIC.
Halftime here at PBA, Nebraska trailing 19 to the Michigan Wolverines, 51 to 32 at the break. It's about dinner time. As you're listening, watching Nebraska play, go grab yourself some Dorothy Lynch homestyle light and lean dressing. Endless flavorabilities.
Time now for a Nebraska Lottery scoreboard. Our scoreboard scores updated from the Acres Broadcast Center. And this is the only Big Ten game this Tuesday, December 7th. Nebraska trailing Michigan at halftime in Lincoln, 51-32. Last night, one game. Iowa lost at home to Illinois, 87-83. Tomorrow, Penn State in a non-con game, hosting Wagner. Wisconsin will be at home against Indiana. That'll be a great game. Ohio State will host Towson in a non-conference game, and Michigan State will be at Minnesota. That'll be another dandy. The games last night, tonight, and tomorrow in Big Ten basketball. Huskers trailing in this one. You know, you could have an even happier holiday with the Nebraska Lottery's Sleigh Full of Joy promotion until January 5th. Enter non-winning holiday scratch tickets, and you'll have a chance to win $1,000, $3,000, or $5,000. Top prize odds vary by game. Second half, Nebraska and Michigan in Lincoln coming up next. This is Big Red Basketball.
You live in a smart home powered by Cox Internet, so you're not thinking about the pizza delivery. You're thinking how nice it is to get everyone together for a fun night. You're not thinking about the pizza. Maybe just a little.
Cox Home Life. Show me the front porch camera.
Pizza!
View your Cox Home Life cameras right from your TV using your Contour voice remote. Visit cox.com/thisishome to learn more.
Advertised features require subscription to Cox Internet and Contour TV. A high-speed internet connection is required. Home Life Security Services subject to Home Life Security Service Agreement. Cox Home Life Services provided by Cox License Entities. See cox.com/licenses.
Freddy's Frozen Custard and Steak Burgers is all about the good and creating more of it. More drive-thru celebrations. More weekend traditions. More family dinners and lunches. More car picnics and road trips. More desserts. Maybe more second desserts. More celebrating being together as much as we can. There's always room for more good and more Freddy's. Keep the good going with a taste that brings you back.
Visit one of our Freddy's 4 Lincoln area locations.
Here is a before winter to-do list from JTech Construction. Let's start with windows. Triple pane window technology has saved homeowners countless dollars on heating and cooling bills. Siding serves a crucially important purpose, protecting your home and insulating it from adverse weather conditions. And don't forget about your roof. Designing your roof should be simple and painless, and JTech offers several payment plan options. One more thing on your to-do list, call JTech Construction, the official exterior experts of the Huskers.
This year, don't just get ready, get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
51-32, Michigan leading Nebraska by 19 points in Lincoln at halftime. Seatbelt use saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up, friends. This message from the MDOT Highway Safety Office.
Got to throw a punch here to start the second half. That was a painful first half for Nebraska, letting Michigan do whatever they wanted. Michigan coming in here just averaging 69 points per game. They score 51
wow.
in the first half, make 9 threes against Nebraska, and really just scored at will. And at that, and our lack of offense really impacted what we did on the defensive end. And just a lack of energy by Nebraska there in the first half. Seatbelt use saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up. This message from the NDOT Highway Safety Office.
19-point hold. The Huskers in here. A couple of minutes from the start of the second half. This series has been dominated with a capital D by Michigan over the years. They have 19 wins to 3 for the Huskers.
They just dominated Nebraska. Just a physical game to start, and it was all Michigan. They got all the loose balls, all the 50-50 plays, and just out-hustled us. And I'm sure there were some choice words used in the locker room by the coaching staff for Nebraska. Hoiberg had to have some words to say to his team, and we have to have some guys step up and be leaders in the locker room too, and rally their teammates and get in their faces and try to get them going. I mean, there's a lot of half left. We've seen stranger things, but you got to try to battle back here, win these first 5 minutes, try to get the crowd back involved and see what happens.
We've seen stranger things.
Yes, we have.
Such as, I mean, not many stranger than
right.
what it would take to get back in this thing, but I don't know. Down 19 points, the tenor of this thing has to change 180 degrees and right away and consistently for any chance to come back.
Yeah, you just look at it where I thought, I really did. I said it in pregame that we were going to shoot the basketball well in this game, start off 3-for-6, and then miss our last 12 attempts. And we had some guys, Breidenbach's 0-for-2, Wiltshire's 0-for-2, McGowan's is 0-for-3, and guys just haven't made anything. Webster's 0-for-1, and had some good looks. And Casey started us off knocking down the first attempt of the game, but then it was slow going after the start. Had the game tied at 13 apiece, and then it was just downhill from there, and Michigan really playing harder and more physical than Nebraska.
So what are you made of? You know,
that's right.
As a player, I mean, playing for the name on the front and the back of your jerseys, and it's got to be a little bit embarrassing at this point for those players that, just as players.
Right. In front of your home crowd, you played hard and tough in two straight road games. You get a chance to come back to Lincoln and put on a show, and instead we've just fallen flat and just no energy defensively. So let's see our leaders, Derek Walker, what he can do. And, you know, what hurts in this scenario, Trey McGowan's, who's our energy guy, energy leader, is on the bench with an injury.
All right, Michigan has the ball to start the second half. Dickinson back to the basket on the elbow to a curling Eli Brooks. Faces up, no shot for him. They come around left side. Now left lane line with it is Dickinson. Walker behind him. Brings him in. Here comes the double team. Shot partially blocked. Retrieved by Dickinson. Skips it out. Now to Brooks. Shoots the three. No good. Grazed the rim. The rebound by Nebraska. Verge comes the other way. Diagonally left to right. Tominaga jump pass down inside to Walker. Back to Tominaga. Deep right corner. Oh, in and out. And the rebound to Johns. Brandon Johns of Michigan in transition the other way. Flips it off there to Caleb Houston. Left side now to Jones, the point guard. Little hesitation move, the drive, puts it up, can't score it. Ball pinned between the rim and the backboard. The rebound by Nebraska. Verge comes the other way. No penetration available for him. Now he starts in, kicks it out. Latman's three. It's no good. Rebound by Bryce McGowan's, and we got a whistle and a foul. He was undercut by Brandon Johns.
Now Bryce is playing hard now. He came out here.
He got hit hard.
Really attacked there, didn't he? And just went right to the chest of Brandon Johns. I thought it was going to be a foul on McGowan's at first, but good hustle by our freshman.
A little low blow there. Bryce crouching down in pain and bounce pass. Huskers with it. Verge has got it off the screen of Walker. Out to Latt. Hands it off to Bryce. The step in. The step back. The three on the way. Short. Rebound Dickinson. And we've got a Michigan Wolverine flat on his back.
I think that's Jones laying down.
Got run down somehow.
I think he got hit right in the side of the head. Caught an elbow. And that's a three we talked about in pregame where it's a step back from the top of the key. It's a really tough shot. When you're struggling shooting the basketball, McGowan's now 0-for-4. And that's not the first attempt that you want. Casey in the possession prior got a good look from the right corner, just unable to knock it down.
I mean, you're early in the shot clock, too.
Exactly. And that's not the one you want to get yourself going on. You want to get a step-in rhythm three, knock that one down. Then if you hit one, then you can take that step back.
Frankie Collins comes in to replace Devontae Jones at point guard. Brooks has got it. to Johns to Dickinson, top of the circle. One dribble to the left, coming out to catch it is Brooks. Reverses left side to Brandon Johns Jr. in the corner. The drive, losing the handle, retrieved by Dickinson. A little soft touch finish, though, by Dickinson. He's in double figures with 11, and it's 53-32, 21-point lead for Michigan. Flat man comes right, coming to it is Tominaga. Diverge, swings the ball down low, drives it in the paint. Foul from behind by Frankie Collins. He's good at that.
He is. Try to get a set going to where he's going downhill and try to find some shooters spotting up. He had Lat Mayen wide open in the corner there. We got to get something going. Nebraska down 21.
He can get in front of you and then apply the brakes a little bit and draw the foul from behind. Walker to Mayen. Swings it left on a chest pass to Burge. Crossover dribble to the foul line. Down inside the lane. Puts it up and down. Burge now with 16. First two of the second half for the Big Red.
Burge was going to pick up the pressure there a little bit. Took a lot of contact there on that layup. Just no call.
They're 53-34, 19-point Michigan lead. Frankie Collins to Johns, into Dickinson. Right lane line. Faces up against Walker. Crab dribbles in. Double comes. Open man in the lane is Brandon Johns. And we got an offensive foul on Johns, knocking Verge down, who got there and set up outside that restricted circle.
And a super late whistle by the referee. Juwan Howard not happy at all. I thought it was a charge, but called that right away. I think that's his issue with that call, was just how late that was in the play.
53-34, Nebraska down 19 with the basketball. Can they score back-to-back buckets? Bryce McGowan's dribble weave action comes from Tominaga to Verge. Starts down the right side, stops, spins in the paint, draws a double to kick out to Bryce. Bryce drives the ball, walks with it. But he is fouled en route to the goal. That's why he shuffled his feet.
He got hammered. I think that was Eli Brooks trying to guard him. And they're going to send some continuation there. I thought he got fouled clear at the left elbow. And I thought they blew the whistle way late there too. But that'll send Bryce to the line shooting two.
He scored just 5 points tonight. 2 for 8 from the floor. 0 for 4 from three. Has hit his only free throw. Nebraska shot just 3 free throws. Now 4. As McGowan's hits it from the 15-foot mark, standing on the nail, 53-35. Huskers down 18. They were down 21 a moment ago. And the second free throw won't drop for him. Caleb Houston, defensive board off that miss.
Well, that's big, though, because that's 4 fouls already against Michigan. They only had 6 in the first half.
Houston with a ball to Brandon John. Chest pass left side, Frankie Collins. Screen for him by Dickinson. Pick and roll. Now the rescreen, Dickinson for Collins. Little whip pass up top to Brooks. Brooks, left lane line. Dickinson shoots it in over the right shoulder with the left hand.
Pretty good move right there. I mean, not much you can do against the big fella Dickinson.
55-35, Nebraska down 20. As Verge takes the ball to the rack. Boy, there he schooled his defender there.
Yeah, he did.
Whipping his body right and left and right and left and then finally taking it to the rim.
I thought it was going
to
be one of those possessions where Verge can dribble the life out of it, but Abel to get it off the glass on the left side.
Dribble it so hard it explodes. 55-37, 18-point deficit for Nebraska. Michigan's basketball. Dickinson, short corner left side into Johns, who scores it over the left shoulder with a right hand. Brandon Johns with 18 points now, 20-point lead, 57-37. Here's Verge again to the rack. Runner on the way, draws the foul. And 2 free throws coming up for Alonzo.
We got to get stops. If we want to get back in this game, you got to stop Michigan. And we're in a 2-3 zone, and you let them throw a direct pass to the short corner. And Johns then goes to work. That's just too easy of a pass, especially when you're in a zone.
You bring the energy to game day. Black Hills Energy brings it every day. Here's to Husker fans everywhere from Black Hills Energy, who says go Big Red. Free throw good by Alonzo Verge, 19 points for him.
Verge has had a pretty efficient game, though. 19 points, 8 of 13. Missed his 2 three-point attempts and has 6 rebounds to go along with it.
And the second free throw, good. 20-point game for Alonzo. His best performance this year, 26 in the opener against Western Illinois.
Got to get some stops on this defensive end to climb back in this game.
Down 18, Dickinson with the ball, top of the circle. Nobody in the paint, a 5-out look. Here's Jones, screened by Dickinson. The drive and the finish off the window. So Devontae Jones, who was taken out of the ball game after he hit the deck hard, back in there scoring. Here's Verge dribbling around, back cutting to pass. A dunk attempt by Latt, and he's fouled going to the rim. That's kind of emblematic of this basketball game and the physicality Michigan has in terms of an advantage.
It really is, and Dickinson gives him a look after that. So Nebraska down 20, 59-39 with 15:47 to play here in the ballgame. TPLU saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up. This message from the NDOT Highway Safety Office. Stay tuned. More after the break. This is the Huskers Radio Network.
If you win the Nebraska Lottery's Sleigh Full of Joy promotion, until January 5th, enter non-winning Nebraska Lottery holiday scratch tickets for a chance to win $1,000, $3,000, or $5,000 in one of our three drawings. Choose from $1 Merry Match 2, $3 Holiday Prize Lines, and $5 Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer. Enter the Sleigh Full of Joy promotion, and you could start 2022 by winning a jolly little jackpot. Top prize odds vary by game.
You trained for this all year. Endless hours of cardio, conditioning, and weights. And now you are ready. Ready to trek back to your seat from the concession stand. Through the lines, lost fans, and that mascot who wants you to do a little dancey dance. All without spilling a drop of your ice cold Bud Light. Welcome back to football, sports fans.
A shield against the elements. Comfort in the midst of chaos. Shelter in the aftermath of destruction. For 75 years, Shelter Insurance has remained true to our promise to be there when you need us most. This is the heartbeat of our company, our why. Shelter Insurance. For your auto, home, and life.
See Agent Jackie Rowan in Lexington or Megan Fales in Cozad.
That segment of basketball, Jake, seemed like it was like longer than all four overtimes of last Wednesday.
Really,
I mean, I don't know what. Four minutes and 13 seconds, and it was like a forever. And it's a 20-point ball game at the first media break second half.
Well, there's just no energy here in the arena, and rightfully so. Nebraska, the players have not, you know, played to a level that Nebraska fans expect. And they're just sitting around and Michigan up 20. And I'll say this, though. There's a lot of time left. I mean, as this time wears down, but it's going to start with stops, and we just cannot seem to get a stop at all. And Michigan start four of their last four from the floor. I mean, what are you going to do? I mean, you just can't go try to outscore these guys right now. It's all going to come on the defensive end. And right now, the energy level on that side of the floor is just not there.
Huskers Saturday against Auburn in Atlanta, and then they don't play until the 19th, a Sunday afternoon, a game against former Big 8 and Big 12 opponent Kansas State. Bruce Weber will have his team in here on the 19th. Then one more game before Christmas, Kennesaw State, and then you got a 10-day break before the next game.
Kind of a weird month here in December and in the start of January. But these guys need breaks and try to get their legs back, but man.
Well, next week after the Auburn game is a break for finals. But they put the schedule together this year to give them an opportunity to head home for Christmas.
Which is nice for players. They oftentimes don't get that opportunity to head home and see their family. So it'll be a nice little break and homecoming for some guys here on Nebraska.
That man with 3 points on the evening free throw is in and out. And so Nebraska now is 6-for-8 from the foul line. Michigan has shot just 6 free throws, so 13 free throws taken total in this game. Second one good by Latt for his 4th point tonight. Held to 2 at Indiana on Saturday. Full court pressure by Nebraska in the backcourt. Jones brings it into the front court. Now setting up in the half court, being hounded by Alonzo Verge. Drove right past him, met there by Bryce McGowan's. Backhanded layup, no good. Rebound by Eduardo Andre. Eduardo gives to Bryce, down the floor to Alonzo. Verge waits for his teammates, flips to Bryce. Bryce drives the ball, puts it up against Johns, can't finish. Rebound by Brandon Johns, Jr.
And Johns, Bryce, the physicality just did not allow Bryce to get off the floor.
Caleb Houston out to Johns, shoots the 3, unguarded, no good. Long rebound, Tominaga. No defender on Johns there.
It looked good, too, coming off his hand.
Here's Verge, threads his way down the lane. The kick out, and Latt's three is short. Rebound knocked free into the hands of Eli Brooks, one against two. The trailer is Houston. He's got the ball, and he walks with it, traveling on the freshman, Caleb Houston.
Another late whistle, though. The whole crowd saw that travel, but finally the referee blew the whistle. Man.
How about a little run here?
How about that?
How about that for a concept?
3 of 22.
Did you ever think of that?
Yeah. 3 of 22 from three. Missed our last, 16 attempts.
Down 19. I mean, that's all it would take is a little 6-0 run to get the crowd energized and everybody's hopes back up. Wilcher's got it. Gives to Eduardo. Back to Wilcher on a rescreen. Wilcher out to Tominaga. He drives to the right. Stops. Pops in the lane. Got it. And so Keisei Tominaga with his 7th and 8th points to go with 2 threes on that 2-point field goal. 59-42. 17-point Michigan lead. It is Eli Brooks being guarded by Tominaga out on the floor in front of the Michigan bench on the far side. And we got a whistle and a flop warning or what?
On who?
I don't know. Nobody hit the ground.
Fred Hoiberg over there smiling. What are you talking about?
I mean, if you snap your head back, is that a flop?
Apparently so.
And I didn't see anybody snap their head back.
I didn't either.
59-42. Inbounds pass. Brooks has got it. Screen set for him by the big man Dickinson. Now down the lane goes Williams. Gathers himself. Misses the shot. Rebound Alonzo. Verge down the floor. He's got Tominaga on the wing. And Tominaga to a trailing Breidenbach, kicks it back out to Verge, the pump fake. He drives the ball to the foul line, down the lane, puts it up. Left-handed scoop shot up. 4-0 run by Nebraska. They've cut it to 15. 59-44. Here's a streaking Eli Brooks, and he's fouled hard by Breidenbach. Good, clean basketball play there. So the scoreboards shows a 15-point Michigan lead, 59-44. Foul on Breidenbach, his second.
The crowd not happy at all.
We fouled him.
No, they got the foul on Eduardo Andre.
What?
They called it on Andre. That's what I'm saying. Breidenbach was up against the backboard, beating that thing off the backboard. A clean block. They got Eduardo down low.
And Brooks hits the first free throw.
Yeah, finally some life here at PBA, and have a chance to block the shot, get out in transition again, and, man, just can't get a string of stops and a string of makes together.
And the second free throw good, so Brooks gets two from the line. Foul on Andre, his second. Full court pressure, 1-2-2. With it is C.J. Wilcher to Alonzo Verge. He lost the ball, got it back, brings it across the timeline against Brighton with a screen by Breidenbach to Wilcher. The sidestep, three on the way. No good off the back of the rim. Rebound by Andre. Outscrapped Dickinson down in the paint. Wilcher, ball knocked free into the hands of Jones. Michigan the other way. In the corner, Eli Brooks puts it up. Got it. Three ball. Deep left corner three.
So we miss one. Get the offensive rebound. Turn it over, and they knock one down.
64-44, and the return three rattled home as Alonzo Verge took no time to square up and shoot it. He's got 23.
We don't have the luxury to run clock. We need those quick makes. Nebraska down 17.
Actually, Verge has 25, I beg your pardon, one under his Husker career high. Dickinson left side, Brooks feeling it, shoots another three, nails another three. Back-to-back threes by Eli Brooks. And it's 67-47, back and forth we go. Here's Verge driving the ball, he's feeling it, puts it up, and in off the window. That is a Cornhusker high for Alonzo Verge Jr. with 27, eclipsing the 26 he got in the season opener against Western Illinois. And Verge trips up Jones. Literally, Jones hits the deck on an inadvertent trip.
Good sportsmanship showed by Alonzo. They're helping Jones up. This game has been extremely physical. You missed when you were calling the play running on the opposite end. Breidenbach and Dickinson got tied up and hit the pad of the basket. That whole rim was shaking for about 5 seconds. This has just been a hard-fought game, and Nebraska just can't seem to get any stops. We're 4 of our last 5 on the offensive end, but down 18 because we can't stop Michigan.
Eduardo comes out of the game. Now you got Wilcher, Verge, Kobe Webster, Breidenbach. On the floor, Jones has got it. Jones inside the free throw circle, backs up. Bounce pass, medium pivot. Brandon Johns back to Jones. Around the horn right side. Three hot potato passes, and the three is no good. And the rebound by C.J. Wilcher, who gives it to Kobe Webster. The Copester across the line with a flip to Verge about 10 feet away from us as we sit courtside. Verge drives the ball, lost the handle, and a turnover. And here comes Caleb Houston the other way for Michigan to a streaking Williams who finishes with a left-handed layup.
Man, can't turn the ball over either in this scenario. Michigan back up by 20.
69-49, Huskers down. Tominaga with a basketball, whip pass, right elbow. Breidenbach couldn't handle it. Jones on the steal, the lob to Houston, the layup good. And Michigan up 22 points, their biggest lead of the night. With 11:55 to go in the game, it's Michigan 71, Nebraska 49. And this is the Huskers Radio Network.
See beyond traditional security with Kidwell. Kidwell's experts collaborate with its data cabling and IT teams to design and install surveillance camera systems that integrate with your network, are easy to manage, and can be accessed from anywhere. The Kidwell team assures every piece of technology performs seamlessly and creates greater confidence and a higher level of protection for your business and staff. From video surveillance to information technology to data cabling, see beyond to what's possible at KidwellInc.com.
From sprains and stitches to sore throats and sinus infections, when it's care that can't wait, count on CHI Health Clinic Priority Care. Simply walk in 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. You'll get the quality care you need without an appointment, and you'll never pay more than a regular primary care visit. Get in, get out, and get on with your day. Find a location near you at chihealth.com/priority care.
Welcome to Ag Answers. Today we're talking about renewable biofuels like corn ethanol and soy biodiesel. Electric vehicles continue to make headlines as we look for ways to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. But did you know by using ethanol, you can reduce greenhouse gas emissions by up to 46% compared to traditional gasoline and by up to 86% when you use biodiesel compared to petroleum diesel? Locally produced biofuels are the here and now solution to combating climate change. They are good for our air, good for our wallets, and good for Nebraska. This message is brought to you by Nebraska's corn and soybean farmers.
Michigan leading Nebraska 71-49 with 11:55 here to play. Their biggest lead of the game here at PBA. Husker fans, shop Woodhouse first. 18 brands, 16 convenient locations, simplified car buying to save you time. Shop, finance, and buy online at woodhouse.com.
Alonzo Burge Jr. has scored 27 of Nebraska's 49 points tonight. He's taken 16 of Nebraska's 49 field goal attempts. Hit 11 of them, 1-for-3 from 3, 4-for-4 from the line, 7 rebounds, 3 assists.
And what's crazy is, too, Alonzo Verge has 3 assists. How many does Nebraska have, KP? 3. So we've got 3 assists on 19 made field goals. You contrast that to Michigan, what they've been doing. They've got 17 assists on 26 made field goals. So just completely different offenses right now. We're playing a lot of one-on-one basketball. And it's just been a game where we haven't made any shots. We started off 3-for-6 from downtown. And right now we're one of our last 18. Think about that.
Did you ever think about that?
Exactly. And I look at the guys shooting the ball and what we've done. Breidenbach got a couple of really clean looks. Wilcher missed 2 wide open ones. Webster missed 1 wide open. And the flip side is Michigan knocked down all theirs. They're 11-27 for 40%.
What did you say that stat was on the field goals?
We are, what do you mean, our threes? We were started off 3-for-6. We made one of our last 18.
All right, here's Bryce McGowan's with the ball on the midcourt, right side of the floor. Screen for him by Breidenbach. Comes left of the elbow, kicks it out now to C.J. Couple of steps to the rim and finishes with a kiss off the window. Nice take there by C.J. Wilcher for his first 2 tonight.
It's a great execution out of the timeout. And Breidenbach did a really good job sealing Johns off so nobody could come over and block the shot of Wilcher.
Sorry about that. Jake Jones with a ball to Johns with a handoff to Houston, who came to it from the weak side. Back inside, Johns puts it up and in, and an and one for Brandon Johns Jr., who just loves to play against Nebraska. He's got 20. And we've got a timeout on the floor with 11:22 left to go in this one now. And We'll keep it right here, down 22 points, 73-51.
And just our defense. I mean, that's it right now. Where Michigan shooting 51% from the field and getting whatever they want. Nebraska's not putting up a lot of fight. And that's the thing that's really going to make Coach Hoiberg mad, where at least in the games we lost, the last two, NC State and Indiana, we could look at ourselves and go, you know what, we've played extremely hard on the offensive, or excuse me, on the defensive end, and really fought and scrapped and played physical. But this game here, I mean, it's been the exact opposite. Our energy has been just lacking. We come back home, we start missing shots, and once we started missing shots, then our defense went downhill from there, and it's been like that ever since. And you're not going to win a game where you let a team dictate what they want to do and do whatever they want on the offensive end.
This is Michigan's first Big Ten game. They'll play their second Saturday at home against Minnesota. Undefeated Minnesota. How about them?
Yeah, how about them? I think the verdict is still out on the Minnesota Golden Gopher team. Haven't beat anybody, you know, in that upper quadrant. But, heck, they won all their games. Got to give kudos to Minnesota. So we'll see what they have against Michigan the next game up. But, man, I thought we were going to play well tonight. And that we're going to come out, shoot the ball well. We really did to start the game, and then get that game tied 13 apiece, and then it's just been all Michigan. And you have to give them a lot of credit. They keep getting a lot better as a team, where they got blown out by Arizona, blown out by North Carolina. But this is a high-quality team. They weren't ranked preseason six for nothing.
Former Husker assistant Ben Johnson, the head coach at Minnesota, doing a nice job. Replacing Richard Pitino.
He's my vintage. He and I played against one another when he was at Minnesota. So
I was trying to think, Jake, was he an assistant for Doc or for Tim? I think it was Doc.
I think it was Doc.
It wasn't here long, 1 or 2 years.
Yeah.
But he was an assistant, and they picked him to replace Pitino, and he's done a nice job. 73-51 here in Lincoln with 11:22 to go in this one.
How good is Hunter Dickinson and this Michigan team? And we are calling this game and watching Michigan without their big fella, Diabate, as well, where the 6'11 has been starting the last couple of games in place of John's. But John's coming out here saying, I don't want to give up my starting role scoring 20 against Nebraska, but I came into this game thinking that we could really defend down low, very similar to what we did against Indiana with Race Thompson and Trace Jackson Davis.
That was the idea.
But our energy level, our intensity, our just aggressiveness on that end has been nowhere to be found.
Brandon Johns Jr. with 20 team high points for the Wolverines, 6 for 9 from the floor, 2 for 3 from three, perfect 6 for 6 from the line, 5 rebounds. Looking for his 21st point and misses. Rebound to Wilcher, and he puts it back to Kobe Webster, who calls for help against the press. Webster bounce pass. Bryce McGowan's in the backcourt. Back comes to Kobe. Kobe across the timeline between two defenders. Gives it off to Bryce in the corner. It's Tominaga driving the ball. Met there. Dishes it off. Breidenbach missed the lay-in. Great dish there by Tominaga, and it's out of bounds. Last touch, fortunately for Nebraska, by Michigan. And, oh, no, Breidenbach is gimpy on his right leg.
That's not good. I think he's going to try to walk it off here.
Maybe he just banged knees. I hope that's what it was.
Yeah, let's hope that's just a banged knee, but he's coming off like it's not, where I hope he didn't pop something there.
R.J. Petig, Nebraska's longtime basketball trainer, will take a look. They don't take him back to the locker room. The inbounds pass to Eduardo Andre, bounces it right side to Wilcher, looking left, has a cutter, instead goes to Andre, gives it back to him on the elbow. Wilcher's three on the way, looked like it was online, but it was way short.
Way short, as Wilcher just struggling mightily the last handful of games.
73-51, Nebraska down 22, Caleb Houston hits a three in the deep right corner. His third three of the game, 11 points, and now Michigan leads by 25, 76-51. 10.5 to go. Webster to Andre with a handoff to Tominaga. He pulls back, shoots up a shot, misses. Rebound to Eduardo, but it's taken away from him by Johns, who was over the back of Eduardo. Foul is on Brandon Johns, Jr. And you see Lap Mahan check back in.
The big Eduardo Andre fighting down low. Nebraska going to be in the bonus the rest of the way with 10:21 to play. But down 25, 76 to 51.
Eduardo has shot 14 free throws this season. Hasn't scored tonight. Is it 9 of those 14 free throw attempts? Scored 2 points at Indiana Saturday. And the free throw is good by Eduardo. For cutting into the lead a little bit. Down to 24 the lead, 76-52. Averaging just 11 minutes per game. Second free throw good. So Eduardo Andre makes the most of his free throw opportunities. And in the scorebook with a couple of points here, 76-53. And out near the timeline, the action, but away from the ball. We got a foul on Eduardo. I don't know what he did there.
He looked like he was holding Hunter Dickinson. At least that's what the sign the referee gave to Coach Hoiberg. But that's one thing Big Eduardo does. He comes in and fights. He ain't going to back down from anybody.
And line out underneath the Michigan basket. Jones throws it into Williams. Looking in for Dickinson. Bounces the ball. It's off to somebody's shoe and out of bounds. I believe it'll belong to a foul on Nebraska here.
Yeah, they call him that
Eduardo.
Eduardo pulled Dickinson down, but it's like, all right. Do you think Eduardo's really going to pull that big guy down like that? I think there was some acting involved. I mean, come on.
That's three fouls on Eduardo. Reset the shot clock to 20. In line out under the Michigan basket. The lob up top to Williams on the left side now. Caleb Houston back to Williams at the point. Back to Houston. Huskers in that zone. High post comes to Williams. Back to Houston. Squares, shoots, three ball, yes. Caleb Houston now with 14 points. And it's 79-53, a 26-point Michigan lead. Kobe Webster fires up a three off the heel. Not good. Long rebound into the hands of Jones. Pushes the ball the other way. A little whip pass in the right corner and a travel called on Caleb Houston.
That's the second time Michigan's five-star freshman preseason freshman of the year in the Big Ten has walked with it, but he's got a great body on him, and he has shot the ball well, hitting down two threes in his game.
26-point Michigan lead here with 9.5 to go in the game. Kobe Webster for the Huskers, and a foul by Jones as Kobe Webster makes his way down the right side of the floor.
That'll send Kobe to the line. I misspoke. Houston has 4 threes in this game. He's 6-9 from the floor for 16. So the 2 5-star freshmen, Houston getting the better of our Bryce McGowans. McGowan just has 6 points, 2-9 from the floor, and 0 for 4 from 3.
And it is Eduardo Andre at the line. Found the foul away from the ball, and he hits the free throw, so he goes 3 for 3. He was sick earlier today, as was Bryce McGowans. His brother Trey also sick. And Coran McPherson not here tonight. He has the flu. They all tested for COVID. I believe they all tested for COVID, and tests came back fine. 79-54 on the second free throw miss. Jones with the ball. Sideline right. Williams fires the three. Got it. Just like shooting practice here.
It really is. That's their 14th made three. Michigan 14 of 30 from downtown.
Williams with 15 points, 82-54, 28-point lead. Here's a three by Kobe Webster, no good. Rebound to Williams. Across the 10-second line, picked up there by Latman. Flips the ball now to Jackson. Zeb Jackson starts inside, tries to dish it off, taken away by Eduardo into the hands of Alonzo. Lost the ball, got it back, brings it across the line, lobs to Eduardo, missed it, got his own missed pass, but he can't score it. That was a lob attempt that actually went up as a shot.
Jeez, and we had 4-on-1 break and don't score.
82-54, 8.5 to go in the game. Williams with the ball, crab dribbles inside over the smaller. Kobe Webster turns and can't score. The tip try, no good. Follow shot up and finally in. 3 tips there by Dickinson, finally got it to drop.
Just no fight by Nebraska tonight. Just no energy.
30-point deficit here with 8 minutes to go in the game. Webster Up near the timeline to Bryce McGowan, working on Caleb Houston on the right side to Lat Mahan. One arms the pass back to Bryce. Bryce comes right off the Mahan screen. The switch. Bryce against Jackson, drives it, tries to finish with the left hand, but draws the foul. Zeb Jackson fouling Bryce McGowan's, who will shoot a couple of free throws here.
Acres Equipment, Nebraska's premier John Deere dealer, with 27 locations across Nebraska and into Kansas. Acres solutions for every field. Michigan up by 30, 84-54 with 7:55 to play. This is the Huskers Radio Network.
Get your free COVID-19 vaccine at Hy-Vee. Go to Hy-Vee.com/mypharmacy to schedule an appointment. That's right, just go online and reserve your time. Getting your vaccine has never been easier. This is your shot to help protect yourself and your loved ones from the COVID-19 virus. Just go online to Hy-Vee.com/mypharmacy and schedule your COVID-19 vaccine. Don't delay. Make your appointment now.
This year, don't just get ready. Get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
You already got the hat, the jersey, maybe even the occasional red and white face paint. So kick things off right this season and add the FNBO Husker Visa debit card to the list. Pay loud and proud for every Husker decal, t-shirt, or hot dog at the game. Wear your heart on your sleeve and in your wallet with the Husker Visa debit card. Free with any checking account from FNBO, the bank of Husker Nation. Get yours today at FNBO.com/Huskers. Member FDIC.
We're going to be on the air at 9:30 in the morning. A little brunch with you on the radio on Saturday morning.
What do you mean to bring you? Donuts or what?
That would not be brunch. I mean, that's just like...
All right, I'll bring you like a ham sandwich and some donuts. Some roast beef.
Do you cook at all?
Yeah.
Do you?
Do you?
Absolutely, I do. Absolutely. I'm not like Martha Stewart.
You like Chef Boyardee back at the Pavelka house? You wear a chef hat when you get all that stuff done too?
No, but I do probably the best grilled steak in America.
All right.
I mean, is that good enough for
Thanks
you?
Thanks for inviting me over sometime. I really appreciate that. But hey, on Saturday morning, I'll bring you some coffee to your room.
Yeah, right.
Get you hyped up for the Auburn game. And hopefully Nebraska brings more energy than what they did here today. Because, man, they're going to watch this film and make themselves stick to their stomach. But 9:30 broadcast for us here.
Yep.
Central time. So people tune into us when they're getting their coffee going.
Yep.
Getting ready to go for the weekend.
Might be some snow to blow on Saturday, I hear.
Oh. Look that far ahead.
Good time to be out of town.
I guess.
By the way, Auburn is absolutely loaded with big guys. I mean... They're huge.
They're a big team. And Bruce Pearl teams, they like to press, play fast, and play physical. And that's not what we need right now with this team how they're playing today.
Only beat Syracuse by 21. Here's Bryce McGowan's hitting the first of a couple of free throws here for his seventh point tonight. Bryce McGowan's second free throw, money ball. And so he's now got 8 on the night. And full court pressure by Nebraska. Verge against the backup point guard, Frankie Collins. Ballyhooed freshman recruit out of Sacramento, California. On the left sideline in front of the Michigan bench. Now up top, 3 ball on the way. Perfect. The lefty, Kobe Bupka, nails another freshman. From Grand Rapids, Michigan. That's his second 3 of the year. 87-56, 31-point lead. The drive by Verge and the finish at the rim with a left hand on the right side of the window.
Got 29.
Yep.
12-18 from the floor.
His career high, 43 when he was playing for Arizona State against St. Mary's. They lost that game, by the way. Here's the drive by Collins and a foul. Couldn't finish. He'll go to the line. Verge had 15 Saturday at Indiana. Verge tonight, 23 rebounds short of registering a double-double, 29 and 7. He's had three double-doubles already this year. Free throw Collins, short.
That made three by Michigan, Kent. 15 makes from downtown. What's the visitor's record for made threes? Any idea?
I would think that would be the job of the color announcer to research while the play-by-play guy is working.
Well played, sir. Well played.
Verge across the timeline, driving the ball. Floater in the lane. No good. And a rebound by Eduardo Andre. Puts it out now to Lat Mayen. Steps into a long three. High Archer. No good. Long rebound into the hands of Michigan. The other way is Bufkin. Out to Jackson in the lane. Dickinson misses the shot, partially blocked by Lat Mayen, and coming up with a loose ball is Tominaga. Chest pass down the left side, holding the ball on the left sideline. McGowan's over the defense on the block. Double team on Andre. Little hook pass out on the right side. The drive, Verge can't finish, and a late whistle and a block called. We had really late whistles in this game. That'll send Verge to the free throw line for
extremely
a couple.
Late. Verge is slow getting up, too.
Yeah, he is.
And looking over at the bench, Breidenbach left the game with a knee injury, and he's not on the bench right now, so that's not good news for Nebraska. Hopefully he's okay, but he's in the locker room with R.J. Pedig, Nebraska's trainer, who does a fantastic job.
Huskers are already without Trey McGowan's, as you know, and can ill afford another loss of a player to significant time. Verge hits the free throw. He's got 30 tonight.
Especially in the front court where, you know, we're lacking size already. And
he's got more energy than anybody
he does.
That plays. Eduardo Andre. Second free throw good. 31 now for Alonzo Verge. 87-60, though. Huskers down 27. Collins flips the ball to Jackson, steps back, comes left to Collins. Got a new big in the ball game. That's Jaron Falds, 6'10 senior, down inside.
A two-point there by Jackson, the lefty for Michigan. And Nebraska just not playing hard defensively. Even if we're down like we are, you still got to play hard.
Verge with the ball, winds his way down the right side of the lane. Tip try off his own miss. Eduardo gets the offensive board, put back in a foul. On his back was Terrence Williams, and Eduardo Andre back at the line to shoot a pair. Huskers down 29 with 5:55 to go.
And Verge forcing the issue. First time he's been kind of forcing things. He's been pretty efficient, but the telling stat in this game, other than the defensive lack of energy, 4 assists for Nebraska.
Eduardo Andre hits another free throw. So Eduardo, with the foul shot, 89-61, 17-point ball game. And he misses the second free throw, and here comes Michigan the other way after the defensive rebound off the miss. Right side of the floor. Williams drives it all the way to the hoop. Strong finish, draws the foul on an and-one. Is that on Eduardo?
I think it was on big Eduardo Andre. That was a strong finish.
Sure was.
By Williams.
We've got a body, 6'7", 230, out of Clinton, Maryland, second-year player. He had only been playing 7 minutes per game coming into this one, Jake.
He's got 17. He knocked down three threes in that first half, too, to really get Michigan going. And Eduardo Andre got his money's worth. That's 5 fouls. He's out of the game.
Williams at the free throw line. 17, 18 points now for him. And the Huskers down 31, 92-61 with 5:40 to go. Kobe Webster, midcourt in front of us, high post. Walker, give and go, return pass to Webster in the left corner. Keon Edwards, 3 ball, won't go. He's yet to score a field goal as a Cornhusker. He has 1 point, a free throw. Down inside, Michigan the other way. Collins has got it, changes directions, hangs in the air, can't finish. Ball tapped into the hands of Tominaga. Across the timeline, on the dribble, the step back and the three, on the way, no good. Rebound to Williams of Michigan.
A quick, tough shot by Tominaga. He knocked down his first 2 of the game and hasn't hit one since.
31-point Michigan lead. They've got the ball. Bufkin dances around down the lane with a left-handed floater. No good. Rebound off the hands of Bryce McGowan's, and now they're going to say it's off Michigan, out of bounds off Bufkin.
And Wolger checking in for Bryce McGowan's. Man, this place was quiet from the get-go. Tied it up at 13 apiece, and all Wolverines the rest of the way.
Kobe Webster to Walker on the right side. Keon Edwards, the baby blue shoes on tonight. Here's Webster dancing around the left lane line. Double team, kicks it out. Keon's got it. Dribbles to the right sideline in front of the Husker bench to Walker near the timeline to Webster. A little step back, long two, won't go. Rebound, Michigan. Coming the other way is Jackson. And the take inside, the layup no good. Put back by Williams, no good. Rebound by Walker to Tominaga. One against two. Tominaga at the foul line, pull up Jay, no good. Rebound, Michigan.
Nebraska, one of their last 15. No makes in the last 3 minutes.
Frankie Collins with the basketball for the Wolverines. PBA kind of lifeless. Here comes Williams. Whips now to Jackson on the sideline to Collins. Fouls in there at the post now. Then the give and go. Fouls with a left-handed hook along the baseline. Scores it. Jerron Fouls from Holt, Michigan. Gets in the scorebook, 94-61, a 33-point lead. Here's Kobe Webster from distance, missed it badly. And the rebound by Bufkin. 3.5 minutes to go. Bufkin top of the circle. Crossover dribble, flips the pass over to Jackson. In the paint, fouled over the left shoulder, can't score it. Offensive board, fouled, tries it again. Partially blocked, and we got a whistle and a goaltend.
Oh, the ball went over the back of the backboard, okay. So it'll be Nebraska ball here out of the timeout.
Hey, if you need to buy or sell heavy equipment, farm machinery, trucks, or trailers, remember Auction Time is the industry-leading online auction platform for big machines. Get worldwide exposure. Earn top dollar for your equipment. Visit auctiontime.com today. This is Big Red Basketball.
This year, don't just get ready. Get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
Nebraska.
If you're doing business in Nebraska, the best way to connect your organization with the excitement surrounding the Huskers is through a partnership with Nebraska Athletics. You can take your business to the next level by reaching loyal Husker fans through in-venue signage, digital and social media, radio advertising, and more.
Got it!
Join the Husker team today and email partners@huskers.com to learn more about opportunities to connect with Husker Nation. That's partners@huskers.com.
CW saves lives and prevents injuries. Nearly 15,000 lives saved per year. Buckle up. This message from the NDOT Highway Safety Office.
33-point lead for Michigan. 3:18 to go.
Yeah, it's been Nebraska's worst game of the year. That's obvious. And just the lack of fight, the lack of intensity, the lack of effort, especially when Nebraska's on defense. And man, they're going to watch this film, and Doc and Coach Hoiberg and Armand Gates and Coach Lenzer. I mean, they're going to have some choice words for those guys in the locker room. And as a player, take some pride. You know, take some pride in what you're doing and putting that jersey on that says Huskers, that says Nebraska. But this was just a domination by Michigan.
This may be one of those games where you say, nobody watches the video. I mean, you know, that happens.
It could, but I think this is going to be one where, I mean, just the plays and lack of communication and things that, you know, that we can control. We talk about, you know, you're going to miss shots, but you can always play hard defense, and we just haven't done it. And you look at our shooting again. We started off 3-for-6 We're one of our last 26 from three. You're not going to win any games that way. I mean, defense or not. I mean, that's just you got to make some shots, but, man, is Nebraska struggling from downtown.
Walk-on Chris McGraw on the floor for the Huskers, along with Walker, Wilcher, Tominaga, and Edwards. With it is Walker, a handoff to Tominaga, pick and roll, return pass on the block. Walker drives baseline against Fouts and draws the foul. Couldn't finish, but free throws coming up for Derek, who has not scored tonight.
Derek plays hard, too. I'll give him that.
Got four rebounds, but no points.
He didn't have a chance. We didn't really feed him the ball down low, and when we're driving it, you know, our guard shot the ball primarily most of the time.
And the free throw by Walker is good, so he is in the scorebook with a point. Last Wednesday, he had a double-double against North Carolina State. Keeping in mind there were 20 extra minutes to that game. Misses the second free throw. It's 94-62. Collins with a ball, high post, fouls back to the basket, way out in front. Pivots, flips it out to Collins. Guarding him is Chris McGraw. Comes to the right, dancing around inside the paint. That high-low, they go into fouls. Flips it back up to Collins, who shoots the three. Missed it. Crashed the boards. Put back up, no good. Put back up and good. Second time by Bufkin.
Michigan's playing hard. I mean, they're still crashing offensive boards and fighting and scrapping.
So it's 96-62, 2:20 to go in the game. Wilcher flips it out to McGraw. Now to Tominaga, shoots up a 26-footer. Got it. Casey Tominaga. First three in a while.
Man, he made his first two. He's one of his last seven.
31-point Michigan lead after that three-point field goal by Tominaga. So they were down 34. Here's Collins down the left lane line. Finishes with a right hand. Like a magnet to the rim there.
Yeah, just easy. Again, Nebraska not taking any pride. I know we're down 30, but take some pride.
98-65, Tominaga with another three. He's knocked down, missed the shot, gets back up, down the floor, and the dunk with the left hand by Bufkin. And it's 100-65, Michigan by 35 points with a minute 35 to go. Wilcher, Tominaga in the corner. Keon Edwards drives the ball to the rim and kisses it in off the glass, and that's the first field goal of Keon Edwards' Husker career. He had scored 2 points on two different occasions. And we've got a timeout on the floor here with a minute 28
to
go.
Just a lineup change. Get some guys in for both teams. And, you know, you look at our bench and Breidenbach's still not out there, so I'm concerned about that too. That'd be salt into the wound after this one.
Jackson Cronin, another walk-on on the floor for the Huskers with McGraw, Tominaga, Edwards, and Wilcher. Minute 18 to go, 100-67, 33-point Michigan lead. Here's Collins driving past Tominaga, flips it out to Jackson deep in the right corner, and he stepped out of bounds. And so it'll be Nebraska's ball. The rematch, two-game series this year, be February 1st in Ann Arbor. Here's Tominaga into the front court. A minute and four to go in the game. Nebraska down 33. Wilcher with the ball. Throws up a three. Missed it. Rebound taken down by Jackson. Jackson with the ball. Leaves it off on the left side. Cleared the bench. Michigan now with 43 seconds to go. Fouls inside. Puts it up and in over the left shoulder, spinning to the rim.
Yeah, it's just one. You don't want to come over and injure somebody with this lead right now.
Here's a drive by Edwards. Misses. Rebound in the lane. Wilcher, but he lost the handle. Down the floor it comes. Out of bounds into the hands of Juwan Howard on the Michigan bench.
Well, two head coaches that could play some ball back in the day, Juwan and
yeah,
Fred. I mean,
no kidding. Across the timeline, Tominaga. We got 22 seconds left to go. Edwards gives to Wilcher. Now to Tominaga. 17 seconds to go. A little jab step by Casey. Another jab step comes right. Now for the crossover and the take with the left hand. Can't finish. 7 seconds to go. Michigan will dribble it out. And the Wolverines have come in here and pounded to the Cornhuskers at Pinnacle Bank Arena. You'll hear the horn. That's the game. Final score, Michigan 102, Nebraska 67. Stay with us. Post-game show coming up, including Coach Hoiberg, all on the Huskers Radio Network.
From sprains and stitches to sore throats and sinus infections, when it's care that can't wait, count on CHI Health Clinic Priority Care. Simply walk in 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. You'll get the quality care you need without an appointment, and you'll never pay more than a regular primary care visit. Get in, get out, and get on with your day. Find a location near you at chihealth.com/priority care.
Looking for a great Christmas gift idea? Look no further than expanding your loved one's Husker closet with an item from the new 255 collection, inspired by legendary coach Tom Osborne. With high quality at the forefront, 255 can be worn anywhere, from sporting events and business meetings to backyard get-togethers. No matter the occasion, 255 is about feeling confident, looking good, and celebrating the remarkable coaching career of Tom Osborne. Shop now at Huskers.com or participating retailers. For more information, visit Huskers.com/255.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, I'm journalism student Grace Fitzgibbon with Campus News. Nebraska's new collaborative biosecurity lab is leading research to safeguard America's food supply against growing threats in partnership with the U.S. Departments of Defense and Homeland Security. The lab brings together world-leading expertise in agriculture and a deep understanding of the complexities of strategic deterrence across the threat spectrum and in multiple domains.
When you're ready to pursue a career-building college degree, go with the school you know and trust, the University of Nebraska. And if you need the flexibility, convenience, and affordability of an online degree program, you can go online with the University of Nebraska. With courses developed specifically for the online learner by our four regionally accredited NU campuses, it's a valuable online education for your very real-world future. Go to online.nebraska.edu to learn more.
This year, don't just get ready, get holiday ready with Ford. And the best place to start is at your local Ford dealer. Whether you're getting out to the mall or getting off the grid, we've got a Ford SUV that's perfect for you. Or check out America's best-selling trucks, Ford F-Series. Inventory is arriving daily, so get the season started off right and get our best offers during the Get Holiday Ready sales event at your local Ford dealer. Best-selling claim based on 1977 to 2020 calendar year total sales.
As the Huskers head to halftime, Frank is off the couch and headed for the fridge. Ooh, but he can't make it because he's so cold. The furnace is out again. But wait, he sees an opening. SOS! SOS, he screams and calls 391-2336. SOS Heating and Cooling, his favorite Luxair dealer. Boy, he made the right call today as SOS is already on the way. SOS is your trustworthy company since 1950, and with Luxair, you get free 10-year labor warranty with a new system. Call 391-2336 or visit soshvac.com today.
Here is a before-winter to-do list from JTech Construction. Let's start with windows. Triple-pane window technology has saved homeowners countless dollars on heating and cooling bills. Siding serves a crucially important purpose, protecting your home and insulating it from adverse weather conditions. And don't forget about your roof. Designing your roof should be simple and painless, and JTech offers several payment plan options. One more thing on your to-do list, call JTech Construction, the official exterior experts of the Huskers.
Let's pause 15 seconds for station identification on the Huskers Radio Network. Nebraska basketball coverage continues with the post-game show, presented by Cornerstone Bank. Committed to providing you game-changing solutions for your financial needs. Bank on a solid foundation. Cornerstone Bank. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender. And these...